there is no honey stored, there's a tiny bit in the corner right here of honey. So these girls are just, they have no room. And these girls, bees with pollen on their legs, are walking around looking for a cell to put pollen in. There's new bees hatching out. Look at that. These cells here were not empty yesterday. So those new bees have just hatched out. Anyway, I'm going to take out this deep frame, move the medium frame down below, and put a frame of honey up here. Honey with some storage room. And, yeah, if I don't do that, these girls are just going to explode. With an observation hive that's out of doors, you have to be very careful not to let sun on the glass, because those bees will cook very quickly. So we use insulation to keep the sun off the glass, but also keep the bees warm at night. So let's go find a frame of honey and room to put that frame of brood. So let me... This box is mostly honey, but I see there's some brood right in here. So there's a queen in there. She's trying honey, and that box is empty comb. These are all solid frames of honey. And this is honey and pollen. These girls need that. Pollen. They're raising brood. Okay. So, I'm going to... I'm just going to leave, and I can take one of these out, don't I? I'm just going to take this one out. I'm going to leave a space here. So it's fifth one in. There's even some brood here. Nice brood pattern. You know, they just don't have enough bees. So we're going to give them that frame of bees from the observation hive. Mm. There's room to put a deep frame right there. Okay. Get that frame out of there. Run an observation hive, it's important to not let them get too crowded. It's also important not to hurt the queen. It'd be nice to find her. See her on this side, so I don't see her on this side. Maybe she's on the upper frame. I'm going to shake these bees into here. Actually, it's easier to do it like this. Check the frame's not here, and I'll put this frame into the other hive. Put this comb down below and put the honeycomb above. And there's the big queen right there. It's important to center the frame in the box, so that it's not too close to either side. If there's too much room, they'll build comb between the frame and the glass. But actually, that's some of the most interesting comb. I'm just damaging the surface of the comb a little bit to encourage the bees to clean those cells out and give the queen some more room to lay in this middle part of the comb. that's all. Girls, move out of the way. Now the bees will build comb on the bottom of this lower frame, and a lot of that will be drone comb. Come on, girls, move. Run away. Close the hive gently just to give the bees a chance to get out of the way, moving it in and out until I can feel it close solidly against wood without any crunching or of bees or pressure. Okay? There's no need to run the screws in really tight, just as long as they're lightly, just so the door doesn't come open. Okay? Now these girls have plenty of room and plenty of food. Insulation back on the glass. So I've solved two problems. I've given a weak hive more bees, and I've given these girls room to grow.